Following the immense success of the French movie Darshan, Amma was invited to Cinéma-Vérité Film Festival in Paris to receive an award for her extraordinary work towards establishing world peace and harmony. World-renowned Hollywood film actress Sharon Stone presented the award to Amma.
Introduce a saint is a big job. To film an angel is something else entirely. The film Darshan is extraordinarily inspiring, but the life of a person who gives themselves of service is something that we can all aspire to. Because it is a choice. It is a choice to lend yourself to the service of others. As Milton said when he was losing his sight, simply to stand and wait can be of service. To stand and wait on another. We are in a time in the world when it is more a time of need than any other. We are in a time when we must stand and wait before we decide our action, because we must do the thing of goodness. We must do the thing of kindness, and we must do the thing of grace. Amma has done the thing of grace with her entire life. She has embraced 26 million people, but she has done this as an action not only of giving, but as an action of example, an example of giving and of goodness, of thoughtfulness, and of waiting on others, of waiting that for them to take her embrace and to apply it to a life of goodness. Please welcome not only this saint and this angel, but this person of active goodness.
ബ്രഹ്മസുരകളും ആത്മസുരകളായിരിക്കുന്ന എല്ലാവർക്കും ലോകാരംഭകാലം മുതൽക്ക് ഭൂമിയിൽ സംഘർഷമുണ്ട്. അത് പൂർണ്ണമായി ഒഴിവാക്കാൻ സാധിക്കില്ല എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ മനോവിഷമുണ്ടാകുന്ന കാര്യമാണ്. എങ്കിലും സത്യം അതല്ലേ.
സിൻസ് ദ ബിഗിനിങ് ഓഫ് ദ വേൾഡ് ദർ ഹാസ് ബീൻ കോൺഫ്ലിക്റ്റ്. Saying that it's impossible to totally eradicate it causes a lot of anxiety. But it's the truth, isn't it? The reason being that good and evil will always exist in the world. In our struggle to accept the good and reject the bad, the possibility of conflict cannot be completely ruled out. Such conflict has manifested in nearly all countries in forms such as internal strife, war, and strikes. Although most wars are generally aimed at protecting vested interests, there have been rare circumstances where the needs of the people were taken into consideration and a greater good was achieved. Unfortunately, the majority of wars waged by man have not been fought to uphold truth and justice, but have been motivated by selfishness. From approximately 5,000 years ago until the rule of the great Indian king, Chandragupta Maurya, founder of the Maurya dynasty, truth and righteousness played a central role in all wars fought in India. Even back then, defeating and, if need be, destroying the enemy was a part of war. But there were clear rules that had to be followed on the battlefield and during combat. For example, foot soldiers were only allowed to fight with foot soldiers, and horsemen could only fight with horsemen. Warriors riding elephants or in chariots could only fight with enemies of the same rank. The same rules applied to those fighting with maces, swords, spears, and bow and arrows. A soldier was not allowed to attack another injured or unarmed soldier, nor would he harm women, children, the elderly, or the sick. Battles began at dawn with the blowing of the conch and ended exactly at sunset, with the soldiers of both sides forgetting their mutual enmity and dining together as one. Battle would then resume the next morning at sunrise. There were even incidents of victorious kings happily returning the entire kingdom and all the riches they had won to the king they had defeated or his rightful heir. Such was the great tradition of Dharmic wars, in which the enemy was considered with respect and kindness, both on and off the battlefield. The sentiments and the culture of the citizens of the enemy kingdom were also respected. Such was the courageous outlook of the people living then. These days, to prevent terrorist attacks, strict security measures are implemented in airports and other establishments. While such measures may be necessary for our physical safety, they are not a final solution. In reality, there is one explosive in particular that is the most destructive of all. No machine can detect it. It is the hatred, loathing, and vengeance found in the human mind. In this regard, Amma remembers a story. The head of a certain village was celebrating his 100th birthday. Many dignitaries and news reporters attended his party. One of the reporters asked him, "What are you most proud of in this long life of yours?" The old man answered, "I've lived 100 years and I don't have a single enemy on this planet." "Really? Isn't that amazing?" the reporter remarked. "May your life be an inspiration to all. Now tell me, how is this possible?" "Well," the old man replied, "it's very simple. I made sure that none of them remained alive." If we don't eradicate our destructive emotions, there will be no end to war and violence. In wars today, the enemy's country is destroyed in every possible way. Conquerors plunder and monopolize the land, natural resources, and wealth of the defeated to use them for their own selfish enjoyment. The culture and traditions that have been passed down for generations are uprooted, and innocent people are killed without mercy. Furthermore, we cannot begin to fathom the amount of toxic fumes emitted by bombs and other weapons of war, filling the atmosphere and polluting the soil. So many generations will be forced to suffer physically and mentally as a consequence. In the wake of war, all that is left is death, poverty, starvation, and epidemics. Such are war's gifts to humanity. Today, some wealthy countries instigate wars simply to promote the sale of their latest weapons. No matter what action we perform, even if it be war, the goal should be the protection of truth and Dharma. Amma's not saying war is unavoidable. In principle, there is never a time when war is necessary. But will we ever be able to completely eradicate war from the external world as long as conflict remains in the minds of man? This is something we really should contemplate.